There are books that you grow up with, there are books that you encounter in your studies, and there are books that are recommended to you by family and friends. As an English teacher, obviously, throughout my life, I have read widely and appreciated literature, most of it classic literature, traditional literature. This is a book that I have encountered in the last few years that has made me sort of reevaluate life. It's called When Breath Becomes Air. It was written in 2015 by Dr. Paul Kalantithi, a neurosurgeon. And he's outlining and evaluating the life that he has lived. Now, he died in 2016 at the age of 36. And the book is really a celebration of life, what it means to be fully alive and fully living. Now, the writer comes from a very celebrated background. He studied in Yale, Harvard, Cambridge. He had a degree in English literature. He also then did his medical studies. So it is a book written by a writer, really, about scientific things and what it means to be human. And I would recommend this book to absolutely anybody and everybody who is thinking about what they want to leave behind and how they want their skills to be celebrated in their life. It's a great read.
So I've been a voracious reader probably since the age of 7 or 8, reading on average a book a week. So I would love to be able to say that the book that influenced me the most was some work of art or a great literary text, but it wasn't. About the age of 14 or 15, I read a book called The Leopard Hunts in Darkness by Wilbur Smith. Most of Wilbur Smith's books are set in Africa. I'd never been to Africa, I didn't even have a passport. But I read this book about this guy going back to Zimbabwe to restore his family farm. And it definitely had an impact on my life, because 10 years later, I got on a plane to Zimbabwe with a one-way ticket, which was pretty stupid. And I just wanted this kind of adventure as well, an adventure. And by luck, 6 weeks later, after getting off this plane in Zimbabwe, I found myself managing a farm in Zimbabwe. So I think what this shows is that books really can show you new worlds, new possibilities, and in a very real sense, change your life.
So I think a book that definitely had an influence on me was Roald Dahl's book, Boy. If you don't know it, it is autobiographical. And he tells the story of his life as a young boy. What I love about the book is, for me, I'm really interested in historical fiction, and although it isn't fiction, it is all based on his life, he tells the story in a way that really kind of captures your attention. There's a great chapter where him and his friends drop a dead mouse into a sweet jar. And I think maybe because I wasn't very naughty at school, I quite like reading about things that people did that were a little bit naughty. But it definitely captured my attention and was told in a way that really kept you interested in what was happening. So I really loved that book when I was younger.
The character that has inspired me the most is actually The Peter First, which was written by Leo Tolstoy. I remember reading this book when I was in 6th or 7th grade. This book was massive, and to be honest, it was intimidating for me to even open it. But once I started doing it, I realized how much I enjoyed it. And the character of Peter First resonated with me the most, and actually I think left a big impact on me, was because that he was a fairly young Tsar, even though he was a young man who was still learning about the politics and the mind games. He still managed to bring the creative and innovative ideas to the table. And what's interesting is that I remember when he was joining or attending those like social events, at that time, according to the Russian etiquette, he was supposed to write or speak in French or German, and that actually the love of languages was that I read about it in that book, and actually that stemmed from my curiosity to learn French and German, which maybe wasn't that successful, but still it inspired me, and I'm still grateful to that book and to my teacher to this day.
I remember as a child, my father, who was very passionate about cars, used to read to me the story of Ferrari, and he talked to me about, and he read to me about the character called Enzo Ferrari and how he developed the Ferrari Motor Company, and particularly in motor racing. And in his day, Enzo Ferrari was groundbreaking and the things he was doing and how he moved cars forward. So I think that's probably somebody who I aspire to. He was always looking for the advantage to beat his rivals.
Since I was a little girl, I've been inspired by Agatha Christie's, the world-renowned private Belgian detective Hercule Poirot, who is unsurpassed in his intelligence and understanding of the criminal mind, who is admired and respected by the police forces across the globe. I believe Agatha Christie's books, they develop critical thinking skills in children and imagination. I love and admire both the books and the TV series, starring amazing actor David Suchet.
One of my favorite books is The Day That Lasts More Than 100 Years, written by Chinggis Aitmatov, Kyrgyz writer. A novel is very deep and thought-provoking. It's a story of a man, Buran Yedige, who travels his way to the funeral of his friend, and along the way he remembers different parts of his life, preparing himself to death as well. I really recommend it to all of you, since it's very important, especially considering the fact that it was written during the collapse of the Soviet Union, and a lot of things that couldn't be written before was mentioned there.
Once in a House on Fire by Andrea Ashworth is one of my favorite books. It's a book that I enjoy rereading, mainly because the language is just so rich, so powerful. It's a really interesting book and it has definitely inspired me. So this book is a memoir of Andrea Ashworth's life. It is set in Manchester, which is the city that I grew up in. And I think what kind of really inspires me about this book is our main character, Andrea, just falls in love with reading, and through reading, her life completely transforms. She goes to Oxford University, she's now living in the US, and all of that was really done through the power of reading and books and everything that I love about being an English teacher, really. So for me, this book is really important because it really does show you that it doesn't matter who you are, if you can grab hold of books and reading, it can really take you to lots of different places.
First, and probably the most important character of any book that has kind of inspired me, is Yossarian from Catch-22 by Joseph Heller. Yossarian is put in a very, very difficult or Catch-22 position, and the story is of how soldiers have to make different difficult decisions between life and death. The book and the character are very important to me because of the fact that we're all put in difficult positions throughout our lives, and we are in a difficult decision-making business that is life. And the way Yossarian makes his decisions and the way the book concludes is effectively how we should all be living our lives. Make decisive decisions, stand by them, and then hopefully that your life will come good.
My first book was The Monk Who Sold His Ferrari. I totally can recommend this book because this book can give you more information about life that you have started. If you are in age like 20, 21, this book will be perfect to start to read. And the second book, it's this book more hard to read, and you need to have some life experience to understand this book. Maybe some bad life experience to understand this book correctly. This book named The Words of Edification or Abay Kunambayev. This book feels like conversation, deep conversation with a person, literally with Abay Kunambayev, like you're sitting near him and listening what he's saying, asking you some questions, and just try to understand feelings and thoughts about Kunambayev.
Tolkien is my favorite one. I started reading these books in my childhood, and still for many, many years it's the famous book in the fantasy. There are three series of this title, and the first, my favorite one. In this book I just found interesting, and just I just traveled sitting at home. When I was a child, and I traveled through in the past, in the ancient time, and saw different characters, different myths and elves, and I just can express this feeling that the book played in my life.